this next one.
In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. Loving God, as we prepare for our game of Lipstick, we ask your blessings on all teams, the coaches, the officials, and the fans. We enjoy competing, but we ask you, loving God, to remind us to keep our competition in perspective and to help us dedicate ourselves to fair play and good sportsmanship. Give us the joy of your Spirit as we pray in your name, our Father, who art in heaven.
weekend. We welcome you here to Cardinal Stritch High School. Don't have your lights turned back on yet. Got Mike Jamison and Mr. Scott Winkowski. Good evening, sir.
Good evening, Mike. How are you? I'm great. Ready to go.
I know you're always excited. Love having you here. You do a nice job with there come them lights. Now we'll feel a little bit better here. And
As long as I do better than Tony Romo's been doing lately, I'll be fine.
Wow. Well, we can't have an intervention, but you got to come and do the radio show on Saturday morning if you want an intervention.
Well, Saturday mornings are a little rough right now because we've been playing indoor golf on Friday nights, and we don't start until 8:30. So, like last night, I got home at 12:30, and Saturday morning came a little quick this morning.
Starting the game out here a little bit interesting with a technical.
Apparently someone had dunked or was dunking and hanging on the rim before the game. So that starts off the action right now with two free throws and the ball.
Bag's going to get it. And, you got the first one. That's how we're going to start this game off tonight. And, you know, Cardinal Stritch coming off a huge win last night and making things much interesting, and Leipzig's going to get the ball to start this one.
Now, you'd expect a little bit of a letdown from Stritch tonight, although it is senior night, so they had the introduction of the seniors, and we have a pretty packed house tonight. So I don't anticipate that Stritch will let down. I think that they're gonna try to run, and they're going to try to roll tonight.
Kiefer with the first two-point shot of the game there. There's your Yost. Apple to hit the ball. Well, this is my third Stritch game I've done now, and Yost has been the man, the myth, the legend when it's come from three-point land. There's Mag with one. Short. Oh, get it back.
Lipsick's awful small, but they seem to be scrappy, at least on their first couple possessions. So,
well, I think they're you know, Mag's going to do everything he can to you know, keep Hughes at bay tonight. There you go. Oh. I think explosive-wise, Stritch has definitely got the advantage right there, but I mean, grit and heart right now. You know, you might want to say, you know, Leipzig's going to do that. The Vikings, too. How about that pass right there?
Well, the other thing that you noticed, varsity-wise, they only looked like they had about seven or eight kids warming up, so you just wonder how their stamina is going to be tonight.
Exactly.
They do have quite a few kids on the bench from the JV team, and so we'll see how that goes.
Hit it too. You walked on there?
Yep.
6:20. You know, it's going to be a mistake game. Who's going to make the most mistakes here? And if the Vikings can, you know, play the press pretty well, and look at them two go at it.
That was a good take by
Paul Mag is his name.
Paul Mag. All right, I got it.
Oh, you can sit down there, hon. I think you'll be all right. Just be careful. We've got power right down there. You don't want to mess with the power. Oh, that could be there's the first mistake for the Vikes. And they're quick. They're a quick team. Burton out at point again, and like Burton out at point, and you know, yesterday Hicks was the star, making things happen. We haven't seen him yet. He hit the shot that beat Emmanuel Christian last night. Well, Burton for a couple. Going to turn into a chess match.
Well, Lipsick's been very patient against the press, and they've actually gotten one free basket off the press on a long pass, and they've done a really nice job.
Lift is right now. Burton taking it all the way. Dumps it off to Hughes. He's going to figure out a way to get that ball in the hole. Now, that's how I used to play basketball. Do you remember that?
Well, I do remember that, but the one thing there that was the issue, he could only move to his right because he hasn't worked well enough moving to his left, and so by the time he caught that ball 2 feet from the basket, he took an eight-footer.
Yeah. Got the rebound, though. Hughes bringing it up, got it over to Burton, and...
Burton used his offhand there to push off, so that'll be the foul there. That's one thing that, you know, you don't talk about in practice, and coaches are adamant about this. The one thing that you work on in practice is trying to get your moves going in both directions. Right, if you're right-handed, you got to work on your left. You got to work on going to your left. You got to work on going to your left because you're such a better player if you're able to go in both directions than if you can just go one way.
Exactly. Because couldn't set that better anyway.
Well, because I can guarantee it. Even though tonight's game is a non-league game, there are probably some coaches that are going to watch this stream of Stritch and figure out how we can defend them. And if you know that one person is not going to go to his left, you know that you can play him that way.
Seven right now. Lipsick's big lead for them.
You know, and that's one thing that's changed since we played with all these streaming services and, you know, between what we have. It's a lot easier. It's a lot easier now to scout your opponents than it was back when.
Sure.
You know, we didn't have videotapes of and if we did it, you know, maybe once or twice a year we got to see our own.
Moving that ball around pretty well, getting through the press, good. But I think the bigness factor is gonna, like you were talking about, you know, fatigue's gonna set in on that. Well, there you go.
Nice play there.
Mag again inside. Staying here. Gonna stay with the.
That was a pretty good block. You know, and this is where both teams have to watch it, because actually the team that looks a little tired right now is Stritch.
Yeah.
You know, they're trying so hard to open this game up, and sometimes that takes a little more out of you than it should.
Oh, nice move inside. Gotta make them. He's gonna go to the line for a couple.
Well, again, Cam Hughes is very, very good, very talented, but the one thing he needs to work on is his left hand and his shooting with the left hand.
A little bit deeper there, trying to trap it. There it is. There he is. Ooh. There's a walk and a half there.
Well, I tell you what, Burton always has his hands on the ball.
Yeah.
He is so quick. He gets at it. Tell you what, Lipsick's moving the ball around well enough. If they don't turn it over because of the quick hands of Stritch, they've been getting good shots.
I see what you're saying, though, with the fatigue factor here. Nice. They're quick.
Well, and most important, this is where Leipzig needs to use their timeouts. They need to use the clock a little bit, and they need to use substitutions. That'll slow and give their guys a chance to rest, even though, you know, they're not taking people out. But if you put somebody in every time, at least they get an extra 15, 20, 30 seconds to catch their breath.
A lot of numbers that we don't know that are coming in here.
Yep.
So that means JV. Nice inside move right there. Burton. Oh, three guys.
Nice pass from Burton. He got caught down in the block and waited for Hughes to get open, and Hughes did get open. That's the other thing that's going to happen. The fatigue might not show up on the court, but it's going to show up in the fouls.
Yes.
And you're going to have a lot of hand checking. You're going to have a lot of hand fouls and out of position fouls. So Stritch is going to get more free throws over the course of the game.
Got to make these good. I can get some thanks out to Krogan Colony Bank, Colonial Bank, sorry about that. Renewal by Andersons, the Epiphany of the Lord Parish. Dylan Clement at Edward Jones.
Second one's up.
Got it. Yeah, this little trap has really worked well.
There it is. Ooh. Well, you can tell the fatigue. As simple as not coming to the ball on the pass. That's what Leipzig's guards now. They're standing and waiting for the ball to come to them.
Yep.
And Stritch is intercepting those passes or tipping them or getting a hand on them.
That's better. Oh, a lot of dings already. I thought you said your ref buddy wasn't going to blow his whistle tonight.
No, well, that's one. See, he's got one a quarter. That's your quota, one a quarter.
Oh, nice rebound again. And Lemmers. And he's going to take the three in and out.
Well, this is where Leipzig's got to play it really careful right now. We got a minute to go. It's a tie game. They have played very well for the quarter. They can't lose the last minute by about a 4 or 6 point spread here, and all of a sudden they're down.
This point is all their clock. Or go to the foul. Been doing that a lot tonight so far. Fitzgerald going to go to the foul line, take a couple in. Bolero Fun Center on Monroe Street is helping sponsor this game. The Glass City Wranglers will be starting up here in March. And a big thank you out to Mercy Healthcare Partners. Of course, the Winkowski man himself sitting right here in person. Can't get him on the radio show anymore because he's...
Oh, I'll be there. You know, I'm just pacing myself.
I got you. Yeah, I got the second one. Trying to sync the clock up here. Let me see, get inside, in and out. Here's our Houston big. A little early in the set, but Hughes gets it. And out again. Lammers again.
Oh.
That's how you do it.
That's great passing there. They made Stritch pay for the extended defense.
Should have shot it. Special thanks going out once again to all these great people. And, you know, I got to get over it. I got to get my will done with you.
This week. Honest.
We'll get it
honest. We're going to do it this week.
You know what? This is one of our two games for this week. And then we're going to do Thursday night, which it'll be Genoa Rossford girls, because this is a weird week. There's just no games this week. I don't know if it's Super Bowl or whatever.
Well, I've got some time. We'll get it done this week.
Perfect, 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 perfect. So you've hit the ball well.
I'm getting better.
You're getting there. Okay.
You know, I keep track of everything, golf-wise.
Right.
How, when, where, what. I can go back 30 years with scores and stats and things like that. And last year I thought we started playing early in the simulator, and we didn't start until the 1st of February. Last night was our fifth round already, so...
Are you in a league then?
No, but we play on Friday nights. We have a group of... We got about 16 guys that are on a list, and the first 8 to say yes are in each Friday night.
That's two units, right?
So we have two groups and two units, and it takes us about 3.5 hours, and it's a fun Friday night.
Kamaleski pops one off. Didn't make it happen. Lummer's going to bring it back up. Mag again. A little tougher D here from Stritch. A little more man to man ish. Oh. Oh, nice. Nice.
Looks like Stritch has got a whole new unit in. It looks like they got 5 different players in, so they're gonna try to stay fresh.
Yeah, Tommy and, Taylor over the point now too. That's where you're going to see Van Hicks, too, and Kamaleski. A lot of movement here by Stritch. I'm very impressed with Leipzig.
I am too.
Far. They're playing some very nice basketball so far. Mag.
Wow.
Big guy.
That's a big guy taking a 3 and stroking it down. And Lipstick's playing very, very well right now.
Taylor.
And I'm not sure Stritch has had a basket in about the last 4 minutes.
Yeah, it's been quiet. It's been quiet. They're just, you know, Vikings are moving the ball really well and not making mistakes. That's another good thing.
You know? Well, they haven't had a steal in a while, and the offense is moving the ball around. They're making Stritch work for it. And on defense, Lipstick's just letting them kind of shoot it from the outside, and Stritch hasn't been able to make it.
Right. Come down a couple more here.
You know, I've only seen over the last 15 years or so, I've only seen a couple really good three-point shooting teams. And if I were a coach, I think I would let teams shoot the 3 and just rebound, give them one chance at it. And,
sure.
You know, there were a couple teams. There was a start team back in the 90s that was fantastic, that could really light it up from the 3. But other than that team, there haven't been that many teams that have been able to do it.
Jamming it up here tonight. Special coverage here for you, and appreciate you being around. And Scotty, thank you for coming in and doing the game with me.
It's fun coming to Stritch because it's only a block and a half from my house. So I've done nothing all day. My wife was home, and she and I just kind of hung out today, and it actually got me moving around
there
and gets
go.
Me out tonight.
There you
so.
Go.
And the golf tournament was in a rain delay or a weather delay at Pebble Beach, so
it?
They weren't even playing today.
Tell you what, this Breck kid is running the point really good. Oh, look here, Lemerson's side again. like that block from Hicks right there. That's going to be a
That wasn't bad. You know, Lipsick's made some really good passes from the perimeter into the block.
Yes.
And, you know, even though they're outmatched size-wise, they're getting some wide open looks from inside. I think a lot of it's going to come down. The outcome of this game is going to come down whether Stritch can make their free throws or not. They're getting the ball down in the block. They're getting fouled. And they're close to the one-on-one at this point in time. And free throw shooting is going to be very important.
Kamaleski knocks down two for the Cardinals. Keeping with that little bit of a trap. And really hasn't hurt Lipsick that much here in the second quarter.
Well, it hasn't in the second quarter. Burton was the guy that had probably three or four steals in the first quarter.
Right. Mag again with it. Oh. Yeah, she never gotten through. .39 left to go here in the second quarter. 22-18 is our score. Okay, we're going to set everything up again. Kamaleski a little short there.
Oh, that was a great shot there. He used his body to get some space and then was able to control himself and throw it in off the glass.
Impressed so far. Great game for you tonight on Saturday. Thanks for being here. Stritch. Taylor puts it up and he misses.
Oh, that was really a nice move, and he just didn't get it in the basket. Stritch boy can't buy a basket at this point.
Oh, Lemmers.
Another great pass.
Timeout coming. I can't imagine there's not one coming real soon here. Next with it. Willing. Taylor again, 317. Nice, all the way to the hole. Nice job. Special thanks going out to our buddy, Chris Tucker. Helping out here with sponsors for Cardinal Stritch, and thank you so much. And there's a lot more we're going to be talking about them for the rest of the game here, of course. Phelan Orthodontics.
And this might be Stritch's chance. This last 3 minutes of the half, Burton's back in, so Burton's defense is going to pick up here.
He got it too. Oh, got it right back to him.
Wow, that was unlucky there. Burton made a great play to block the three and went right to the Lipsick player, and he was able to knock it in for a two. One thing that's changed the game from when we played, Mike, there's a heck of a lot more dribbling now than there was when we played. Everything was about movement and off the ball screens, and you know, the ball rarely hit the ground when we played.
Oh, nice.
And now there's a lot more dribbling, and so it's a lot more one-on-one moves, and that's where the college game has gone.
Right. It's all happening outside the three-point line now, you know. Oh. Lucky on that, Yost. A little off. We got a timeout.
I'm not sure, but I think Stritch has had one field goal since they had 14 or 12, and that was probably 8 minutes ago. So they've had one field goal in 8 minutes. They just can't put it in the basket.
30 to 20 is our score right now. Lipsick with a 10-point lead with a 1 minute, and it's actually 1 minute and 35 seconds. Sometimes my clock is not right because I'm just a little slow, but you already knew that, so. Computers, I gotta go by what the computer says, you know? So, yeah, it's so nice to come into this old, just things just haven't changed other than the benches and everything. The benches still, were on this side when I played.
It still looks like the same place that, yeah. You know.
And everything was those old wooden benches, and those are out at the horse farms now.
Yep.
Lipsick's come in here, and they're basically doing what they want to do. Touch foul there on Yost. I would do anything for my cheaters right now. Can't believe it. I never forget them.
Well, I got them in my contacts, so that helps me tremendously.
Oh, that, boy. Oh, wow.
Wow.
Is that lemons? Or Lammers?
Wanted Lammers.
Lammers. That'd be three. In and out from Carter. Point guard play from Lipsick's just incredible right now. They're playing their game out there, and that'll be a foul.
Yep. Well, they have three or four guys that have been able to handle the ball, and even Mag, who's big, the biggest one, when he comes outside, he's been able to handle the ball. So they've got five guys on the floor that can handle the ball, and so they're not afraid of having the ball in their hands.
And every one of them can take the ball to the hole. That's a steal by Stritch. Here comes Burton on the line. 38 seconds left, 41 seconds. My clicker is
Are you
slow.
Looking off your, oh, you're looking off your thing, yeah. Okay.
See, but I don't hit the button quick enough, you know?
Oh, manually doing
I'm
that.
I'm manually doing it, yeah. So. But it does make it a lot quicker than the way I used to do it. Burton gets first.
Well, more than likely, Lipsick's going to look for the last shot after this. So if they can control the ball, they're going to have a 10-point lead.
Yep. Burton makes them both.
I'm not sure about that one. He tried to come down with it. He got bumped, and then he traveled.
That's like blowing a whistle, too. Well, you might have to talk to him.
Yeah, it certainly looked like that should have been a foul.
He's getting ready for the Ohio State-Michigan game tomorrow. They want to go home early. Oh, nice.
Oh, big steal there.
It's tough to play a big game against a big foe on Friday night, and then Saturday night have to do it again. Boy, if that would have gone in, I'll tell you.
Well, that was a bad shot, because that's there. You know, they're up 11.
Yeah, didn't
and he
that.
Takes a long three with 13 seconds left. Now all of a sudden they miss it. There's a foul, and they're going to come down and shoot potentially two free throws and cut this to a 9-point game.
Exactly.
And you know, they could have gone in the locker room if they just would have sat on the ball and had an 11-point lead.
Yost got two here. Now, if you're Stritch, do you press on this?
Absolutely. They're going to slow, and they're going to look for another steal.
Yeah.
and almost had it. And he would have had a layup. If he would have gotten that ball, he had a layup. That could have cut it even more. Now Lipsick's going to get two free throws. So
33-24, 5.9 seconds. This is Lammers.
He's had a nice half. He's made a few shots. He's had some nice passes.
Freebies here.
Well, in the way Lipsick's played so far, I can count on them being good free throw shooters. They all have nice strokes.
Kind of team. Yeah.
They all have nice strokes. I would imagine they got a nice foul shooting team.
He got it off. Not that time. Close. 35-24 is our score. Got a couple of commercial messages. We'll be back with more right here on the Toledo Sports Network, our bonus coverage on Saturday Night Basketball.
Danny's Cafe Rossford is open and ready to make your holiday special with great drinks, food, friends, and watch all your favorite sports on our 17 big screen TVs. Some of the best entertainment in the area. Great food and all your favorite beers. Danny's Cafe in historic Rossford on Main Street. Stop by and say hi to the friendly people at Danny's Cafe in Rossford. From the kitchens of Italy to you, Arturo's Pizza Kitchen is the home of authentic Italian food. As one of the oldest independently owned pizzerias in Toledo, Arturo's Pizza Kitchen has been serving since 1988. With pizza, salads, award-winning subs, chicken chunks and wings, mom's own lasagna recipe, and our famous cheese sticks, we have it all. Never frozen, always homemade. Arturo's Pizza Kitchen. Hungry? Call Arturo's, 419-698-1641.
For the best meats around and the best price, get to Frobo's Meat Locker on Front Street in Pemberville. Frobo's family features homegrown meats, and they make a whole bunch of different kinds of items, and they have over 200 different kinds of handmade items, not to mention Frobo's Meat Locker is definitely a bratwurst paradise. They have over 125 different brands of bratwurst to choose from. Be sure to check them out on Facebook or visit their website, frobosmeatlocker.com.
Moe's Place, downtown Rossford, has the best burgers in town and much, much more. Stop by for their famous Flaming Moe Burger. Moe's Place, proud to bring you Rossford High School Sports.
Different problems require different solutions. Seagate Roofing and Foundation Services has been solving water problems for over 30 years. We have the expertise to provide you with the best solution. Seagate replaces foundations, straightens walls, lifts sinking foundations, and waterproofs basements. Get your free estimate before you make a decision because you deserve to have all the facts. We are the local experts.
244 LEAK Seagate.
Janaw Bank is celebrating 120 years. Hi, I'm Marty Sutter, President and CEO of Janaw Bank. Since 1902, Janaw Bank has been caring for the financial needs of our neighbors. Our roots remain as we continue to serve our customers, our communities, and our families. Genoa Bank celebrates 120 years by reflecting on our past and, more importantly, focusing on our future. We will continue to make a positive difference in the lives of those who work, bank, and invest at Genoa Bank.
Skyworks is a family-owned and operated business specializing in new and used aerial work platforms, sales, rentals, and service. In addition to aerial lifts, we offer material handling equipment, construction equipment, sales featuring new and used telehandlers, excavators, skid steers, scissor lifts, boom lifts, and forklifts, and much more. Contact Skyworks today, 419-662-8630. Proud sponsor of high school sports in the area.
Minutes till we start the second half here today. 35-24 is our score. I want to get some special thanks out to our Cardinal Stritch people that are helping us do these wonderful games. And big thanks to Harrison Floors and Brenton Harris. Brenton Harrison has been a 1988 graduate. And he's got his son Samuel, class of 2015. And big thanks to him. Of course, Chris Tucker and Wells Fargo Advisors. Thank you to Firehouse Subs on Navarre Avenue for making this happen. And Johnny on the Spot, the Hatfield Clan and the Brummets, and we really appreciate them. A great Cardinal Stritch name right there. Joe and Jay at Colonial Signs. Dinettes. I'm going to be very bad because my cheater glasses aren't here and I can't see anything right now. Jill Smith at Keller Williams Realty and Phelan Orthodontics. We appreciate them helping out to bring these games to you. You know, BCSN can do some of the games. Can't do them all. And it's just, we're just glad that we're able to. You know, we started this almost 18 years ago here at Cardinal Stritch doing football games. And it's nice to always come back home. And it's about the third game that we've been able to do for the Cardinals. And looking forward to them going very far in the playoffs this year. And we, you know, would love to hear from you if you'd like to text us at 419-514-1302 during the game, you know, and text us and say hi and let us know you're listening. We'd really appreciate that. And we'll have this up on YouTube so you'll be able to watch it tomorrow also. This game will actually air next Sunday on the CW network at 11 o'clock. And on channel 48, which is channel 58. On Buckeye Cable, it'll air at 1 o'clock on Sunday next week. Next week's kind of a weird week for basketball. There's games are just kind of mushed together on certain days. So we'll be doing this, and then we'll have the Rossford-Genoa girls game on Thursday night. And basically, that's going to basically be about it for us next week. And, of course, Super Bowl and everything. And we got about one more week of boys basketball, and we're going to try and get some girls tournament games in there, too. So just check us out on the website, and we'll get things rolling from there. And another one of my dear sponsors, Mr. Scott Winkowski, who's doing color tonight. Well, hell, you're doing a much better job at play-by-play than you're doing good tonight.
Better than Romo?
Oh. Do you really, though? I mean, really? I mean, I like what he does.
His stories are bad to me.
I'm a story guy.
His stories are bad, and
The biggest thing is let the game play.
Yeah.
You know, everybody that's watching the game, they know what's going on. If you're watching the NFC Championship game, you kind of know a little bit about football. And so America knows a little bit something about football. You don't need to tell them that, wow, that was a good pass. You know, sorry.
Well, he remember how he used to, he'd like predict the routes.
Yeah.
And 90% of the time he was right.
He almost thought he was on a tape delay or something.
Yeah,
you know?
Exactly. 51 seconds till we start the third quarter here, and
well, here's my coaching philosophy and my playing philosophy. What I would be telling Stritch right now.
I'm listening.
Stritch normally scores somewhere between 70 and 80 points.
Right.
They scored 24 points in that first half. If I'm the coach, I'm going in there, guys. If we get to 70, we win.
Yep.
Let's go out and run them right out the building right now. And we don't need to play better defense. We don't need to do anything else. But if we put 70 on the board, we win.
Green light.
And let's go.
Green light.
And let's go. And
hammer down.
And
don't even think of first gear.
You know, that's when I used to play Fed ball, we used to score about in the 90s. And when we'd have a bad half and we'd score 32 or 30 at the first half, all the guys would come in and say, oh my gosh, what are we doing? I said, guys, if we score our 90, we win.
Yep,
and
yep,
so
yep.
They just
the truth,
they just
Scotty,
need to turn on the burners. They had a terrible shooting first half. Terrible. And so if they make their shots and they make some baskets, this game's going to all of a sudden turn around.
Lipsick's going to start the third quarter here. Going to go hardcore man. Boy, you can't let them cross across the middle like that, because that's how they got all those points early in the game with the cross in the middle. Oh, there it is.
There's Burton. Burton gets it.
He ain't gonna stop. Wow. Lost a handle on that one. There's Lemmers.
The other question is going to be, can Lipsick keep it up? They had a great half shooting-wise, and now the question is, at what point do they get tired and shots start coming up short? And,
well, you even said it, though. It looked like Stritch was more fatigued than Lipsick was.
Honestly, they did.
There it is.
That's it. There's Hughes. He's got to get going. He made a nice move there. It took his time. A lot of patience.
I keep hearing that the little engine that could. He just walks.
Yep.
Yes, he did. I've seen that two or three times. They haven't called it tonight. So.
Well, some of the times the travel's been caused by a bump, so they don't call either one.
Oh, that makes sense.
And so you got to either call the foul or call the travel, and so sometimes you don't call anything.
Right. All the way, Burton. Oh, beautiful job. Beautiful.
There's it. Stritch has already had two good possessions right out of the gate, and all of a sudden it's seven, and now Lipsick's got to be a little worried now about the comeback here.
There's the third one.
Oh, and there's...
Oh, wow. There's that timeout.
And all of a sudden, 6-0 run to start here, and they're off and running. And Hughes did a great job of using his left hand there. I got to credit him because I criticized him in the first half about not using his left hand.
I figured you want to move down a little bit.
Oh, okay.
I know the girls, they always forget about us.
They're fine. I don't need to see the game to talk.
No. You got it down to science here.
Well, we did get a compliment from John Utter. John thought he was listening to the game. He said, you guys are doing great. And says we're coming in loud and clear.
Talk about golf. When I talk about my golf game.
Well, the highlight of golf today, I did see a blurb today. Greg Norman thought it would be a good idea.
Oh, no.
A Ryder Cup live versus PGA Tour.
Ooh. It's going to eventually happen.
It would be the biggest rating in golf
right
all
now,
time.
It would be. Well, see, I'm a little worried now because Liv has got picked up by the CW network.
Correct. That's
and
great.
And that's where my shows are on at noon on Sunday or on Saturdays.
Well,
I'm a little worried.
I think they got a little more money to spend than you.
Couple. So we may have to move our golf show and everything.
We don't know yet. So
Yeah, that would be that would certainly be
another one. Oh, that's a lot of stealing right here.
Yep.
Right, we can't see.
Stritch, all of a sudden, Stritch has some energy too. It's they've turned this into a 5-point game, and they got a lot of energy.
Trying to get some attention here, if they can.
Oh, the girls are fine. They're
you sure.
Yeah, I can see it.
Okay. 56. I'll move over as much as I can here, Scotty. So
no, you're fine. I'm okay. Sure? Yeah, I'm fine.
People always forget about us. Wow.
You know, the threes that I didn't play with the three until I was in college.
Right.
And so the high school game, it's a long shot for a high school kid.
Exactly.
But it is amazing how much easier that shot is when you catch the ball and the ball's coming while you're squared to the basket.
Right, right.
When you catch it on an angle or you catch it from behind, it's really a hard shot for most people. So the goal is to create the ball inside and pass back out to the three where everything is square to the basket when you catch it.
Boy, the defense is just brought it up a six. There's a miss right there, and Burton got that one. Nope.
I tell you, Lipstick is playing awful hard.
One's going to the line here, and Lammers.
Lammers, he stroked two in the first half. I'd be surprised if he's missed one for the season. You're fine.
That's his first miss. Because Lammers hasn't missed from the line.
And two things happen when good free throw shooters miss. It's either concentration or fatigue.
The second one.
And fatigue brings on a lot of factors. It brings on a lot of lack of concentration. It brings on a lot of poorer things.
There's Carter.
He's been a little absent tonight.
He had a great game last night.
Yep.
That's going to cause some fouls right there. I don't know who will get that one, though. Who are they giving it to? Oh, they're going to give it to Carter?
Yep. Now, it's tough for kids when they have a big game on Friday night, and then they have to come right back to another game on Saturday.
Yeah.
Unless you play a lot of Saturday games, it's different because it's a different flow to everything. And I know that
as fast as they play.
Well, and I know in our day, Saturdays was always CYO basketball day.
Yeah,
I would ref all day.
Yeah.
And so if I played on Friday night, I'd go ref on Saturday during the day, and then I'd have a game that night.
Yeah.
So Saturday nights can throw off your whole schedule of what your body's used to doing.
There's Carter. He made that one happen. Do you remember who the guy that was running it back
Eddie
there?
Rutherford.
Well, Eddie Rutherford and Wild Bill.
Yeah, and Bill Sanford, right.
No, but Wild Bill Lauer.
Oh, yeah.
Remember Wild Bill?
Yep. And so I roughed a lot of games here at this gym.
Oh, yeah.
At Stritch, I did a lot of games at Central Catholic. And then I used to do the Sunday nights, the Federation,
the old
guys.
You ref those?
No, we wouldn't ref them. We'd score keep.
Oh.
And so Luke Murphy and I, the two of us, would be at Westminster Gym every Sunday from 4 o'clock to 10 o'clock. And one person would guard the door, and one person would do the scoreboard and the score sheet at the same time. And you'd switch every game. And so that's how I got to know Luke Murphy, is I spent every Sunday with him.
Luke played on my Fed team forever and ever and ever. Incredible guy.
Well, Luke's been playing with us on Friday nights.
He's
been playing golf with us. He's a real good golfer, and what a great guy. What a great guy. He's now assistant athletic director at Wake.
Golf coach too, right?
And golf coach, yep. And I can tell people, if they want to give to a great program and help out a team, is throw some money to Wake High School's golf team.
I've got some golf clubs. I've got to get a hold of Luke.
He is trying to do some great work over there.
43-38. Folks, we got a 5-point game now.
There's a nice pass. I tell you, Burton has a great game for his quickness and what he does with the ball. He tends to make the right decision a lot of times during the game.
Got to stay here. Turned out to be a hell of a game.
Sure is. Lipsick's played really well now, and if they can hold on here, the goal here for Lipsick is to not lose control over the next 3 or 4 minutes.
Oh, that must be Mr. Utter.
Yeah.
Great dude. Appreciate y'all watching. Glad we got it nice and clear for you. The refs are doing a pretty good job tonight, so we can't even give them any.
No.
They're doing all right.
They've done all right. It's been a pretty clean game.
Yeah. It's not often, you know. Last night I had Ronnie Gladio do the game with me.
Okay.
We went over to Cinco de Mayo is over there in Rossville.
Oh, okay.
We got to see Steve. Steve's last name, Ronnie's brother-in-law, Steve.
Kolinsky.
Yeah.
This is another Polak.
I know, yeah. You ski.
We all look the same, right?
When he bought me dinner, I was very impressed.
Well, I need to make it over. Is it Danny R's, J's, Danny's?
Danny's. Brad Morrison did a wonderful job at Danny's.
It looks fantastic. I haven't been there yet, so.
And Brad has been sponsoring us for years. Along with you and great people at Genoa Bank and, you know, TAS Electronics. We got some nice people that are getting with us.
Well, I'm excited for the golf show. I'll certainly be there for some part of that day. That was a lot of fun last year. And
you were with us a lot.
I was there for a couple hours, and it's a who's who day of Toledo golf. So.
And even if it's just people walking in that aren't even part of the show that come and sit in with
us. Absolutely.
You know, it is. It's a good time. Danny Sutton, of course, will be part of it all.
Yep.
And Danny's getting ready to fire up the big turbines over there at Heather Downs and get ready to rock and roll. And Brandywine's putting in three simulators.
I heard that.
They should be done this week. I missed them both. That going? Staying there?
He threw it the other way. The Lipsick player made a great move. He threw it. He actually threw the ball to Burton, and Burton was standing out of bounds, and Burton caught it. So what a great play by the Lipsick player.
Can't teach that, right? Well, Stritch has definitely stepped it up here and really did what they needed to do, won this quarter so far. And they're not getting to the basket like they were in the first half.
No, not at all.
I say that, and he should have gone. Oh. This goes down. I like this group here right now with Stritch. This is a nice group right here.
Oh, Well, you know, Stritch has, they got about 8 or 10 players that are really playing, that are really good. Sometimes that's a problem for a coach because you almost got interchangeable spots and you're trying to catch fire at this point in time when sometimes you want to live and die with your 6 or 7 or whoever it is.
But when you've got 8, that gives you more of a chance to have, you know, number 12 be hot that day or number 6, you know. That.
And you're hoping as a coach you got him in on the right day. Now, you thought you were hot all the time, so you didn't ever want to come out.
Dude, I never came out. I played most of the game. But I only scored 5 points a game, you know. Let's go get that one.
Wow, that's it.
Nice.
Well, my thing was, and I had this out with Coach Axe. I played with Coach Axe. Coach Axe thought I played better coming off the bench.
I never started the first part of the year.
Well, and I didn't like that because I liked my name in lights, and I liked being introduced, and I liked coming out on the floor, and I liked knowing that I was starting and knowing I was doing that. And he thought I started better. He thought I came off the bench better. Well, I wouldn't start the game, and about the 3-minute mark, I'd go in, and I wouldn't come out the rest of the game.
Yep.
And then the second half would start, and I wouldn't start, and I'd go in with 3 minutes to go, and I'd stay in the rest of the half. And I'm
he did it with me.
So I had to sit down with Coach Axe, and I said, what's the deal? And he said, well, I don't think you start quick enough. You don't look like you come out of the blocks well enough. Well, I said, give me a chance. I took 8 shots in the first quarter against Mommy in that first game. I shot it every time I touched it.
I hope about half of them went in, right?
And you know what? I started every game after that.
There you go. I just was always worried about getting in foul trouble because I was Bill Laimbeer.
Yeah.
That was my job, to beat everybody up. And it got kind of crazy.
Yep.
21 seconds left to go here in the third quarter.
Well, see, I was the passive Bill Laimbeer because I took charges all over the place.
I don't remember taking two. I'm sure I did, but.
Well, Coach Axe gave out T-shirts. Every 5th charge that you got for a charge you took, I got about 6 T-shirts that year.
I just beat everybody up. I'd walk up to the biggest, meanest guy out there, and I'd say, you're mine, and he'd laugh at me.
Well, you know, at the time, my senior year, I was 6'2", 145 pounds. So it didn't take much for me to draw a charge.
Yeah, but you were a 3 guy, right? You were 3.
I was a 3.
3, maybe 4. Yeah. You know, they had me at 6'7" in the play thing. I was.
I thought I was a 2.5. You know, we ran a motion 1-guard offense. So the 2s and the 3s were kind of interchangeable.
Right.
With the motion offense.
Well, guess what?
We got a great game.
47-44 is our score right now. Getting ready to start the fourth quarter right here on the Toledo Sports Network. Stick around. We'll be right back.
At Heben, Murphy, and Lewandowski, we deal with contested wills by breaking down the legal terms involved and making this complex area of law as simple as possible. If you are involved with a case in estate or probate litigation, we would be happy to provide you with our unparalleled legal counsel. Heben, Murphy, and Lewandowski, downtown Rossford. Contact them today at 419-662-3100. Heben, Murphy, and Lewandowski.
Getting ready to start. Once again, thanking the one and only Scott Winkowski for coming out and helping us here and making things happen. And telephone number if people have any estate planning.
419-690-8022 or 419-266-3886. Call me. That'll get to me directly. And we'll sit down.
I don't have any time this week because you're going to be doing me.
Well, you're going to take a half hour, so I do have a lot of time. Call me and I'll sit down with you and we'll figure out what best you need, both business planning, estate planning, and everything that goes with it.
Oh, all Burton right
there. There's Burton.
Is that Actually, it's 47-46. So I got one too many up there. We'll just wait before I go in and mess with it here. So just know that Stritch only has 46 points right now, and I'm lazy. So, boy, they have just... They just stepped up this outside play.
They sure have.
They just... Carter gets it out to Yost. Over.
Oh, what a pass that was. Great pass there, and Hicks was able to lay it in.
I would say this is the first lead of the game for Stritch.
This is the first lead of the game because we started the game with a technical free throw that Lipsick took the lead.
Oh, nice shot right there.
That's the first time anybody's been open for minutes.
Yep. Bird's going to the line. He is just absolutely the perfect point guard. You know, he just plays so intense, especially on defense, and he moves so well. And, you know, kudos out to him.
Well, I think he's the key to this team. He sets the tone defensively. He looks like he's always playing hard.
Yep.
And he's really good with controlling the ball and getting it to the right guy. And I think if they're going to have a strong end of the season or tournament time here, it's going to be because of his play.
Amen. Got the first one. Tied this ball game up. Second one's up. Used all of it, but made it work. If you're Lipsick at this time, what do, Scotty? I mean,
well, they got to keep moving the ball. They're still in it. They got to keep their composure here. Turnovers the key right now.
Carter with a nice rebound. Gets it over to Burt to get it up the court. Not gonna take the three. He's gonna give it to Yost to take the three if anybody's gonna take it. Now we're gonna work that half-court offense right now. Or Burton.
Wow, what a shot that was. Burton took it right in among two or three guys and lays it in and gets fouled.
I don't think you could even turn that well. I mean, maybe.
I couldn't do any of the things that Burton can do.
148, you might have been able to do that.
I couldn't do any of the things Burton can do.
Wow.
You know, today's game was not my game where you did everything with the ball.
Yeah, but you were quick.
Well, everything I did was without the ball, though. I moved and got open without the ball. And by the time I got the ball, it was ready to be shot. It wasn't I rarely dribbled.
Yeah, Coach McQuaid would yell at me if I dribbled.
Yeah.
I mean it. He would yell at me.
And you know, I rarely passed because I was always taught that a bad shot is better than a bad pass.
Oh, there you go.
So.
There you go. the things you learn.
Well, at least a bad shot can go in.
That's true.
A bad pass never goes in.
Ah, them were the good old days.
This is probably the biggest possession of the game for
definitely.
Lipsick right now. Down five. They haven't gotten many good shots.
Well,
Lammers does a nice job of drawing a foul there.
That's what he had to do. He had to do it. Nobody was open, so he was going to make something happen there. Well, this stops the clock and gives. He makes these. Ooh. That was monstrously short.
That's where the fatigue comes in right now. You're starting to lose your legs.
Yep.
And Lipsick still has three timeouts. I would not die with timeouts in my pocket if I'm the Lipsick coach. I would give my kids as much of a break as they could. Mag needs to step it up here. He's had a pretty quiet second half.
Yeah, he has.
He traveled. There's a travel. He did a nice job of catching himself, and then he leaned in, and Hughes backed off of him, and he didn't have his balance, and all of a sudden it was a travel. So I think they've done a nice job on Mag this second half. It's amazing in sports how a halftime intermission can change something. From where you can go playing in the first half to where you can go playing in the second half. It's amazing how drastically different those two things can happen.
Grant Hicks for two there for a stretch. Bringing the A game here for the second half.
There's another turnover.
Burton's going to go all the way.
Oh, nice pass.
Oh, he's just wondering on that one. So am I.
Well, that was Hughes got caught a little bit off guard there. That ball, the first layup, didn't even hit the iron and just skidded off the other side. And Hughes kind of got caught in no man's land there. He was in a position for a rebound and then got his hands up.
Tommy Taylor back in for Stritch. Another miss. Wow. Big misses here for Lipsick from the free throw line.
Yep.
The second half.
Lammers has played awful hard the whole game. I don't think he's come out.
No. And, I don't think he has either.
He's been guarding Hughes and Hicks, and you know, he'll have a sore bus ride home.
Up. That's about all they're going to give you right there. So if you're going to stop and drop and pop right there, that's about all you're going to get. But they're still not turning the ball over that bad. I mean, you know.
Well, they haven't turned it over in their set offense. They've turned it more over in the open floor.
Wow.
There's your man Burton in the right spot at the right time.
Not a foul there, but that's going to be a turnover back.
Oh, my God.
And another turnover.
He's going to get to it. Oh, he did, but.
Well, Lipsick's doing a lot of the things they didn't do in the first half. They're turning the ball over. Well, that's not something they did early.
Nice. We're going to call timeout here.
If Lipsick can catch their wind here, they can stay in the game. But I think they're getting a little ragged at this point, and Stritch is still fresh.
Yes. This game up for you here. I probably can put the thing up tonight. Now with the new system, I can just automatically put them up.
Well, you're going to Danny's. You need to, you know.
I have me some good grub.
There you go.
Give me some chicken chunks. You know, I'd eat their chili dog, but honest to God, their chili dog is the size of Vermont. It's so big. And it's a wonderful hot dog, but you just can't eat that big a hot dog at, you know, 9:30.
Well, we've given them a couple plugs now, so you can actually go in there tonight and say, hey,
Brad,
pony up a little bit.
Brad takes very good care of
it. I know he does. I know he does.
Brad takes very good care of it. But actually, I'm Wednesday night, his son is playing in the 8th grade facet.
Oh.
And we're doing it.
Oh, good.
We're going to do it at 4:30.
All right.
So
you're not doing anything, you're going to come over and do eighth grade basketball. You know, oh, that'll be hilarious.
Let me know.
Yeah.
Let me know if you need somebody.
He still hasn't gotten the okay from Oregon schools yet.
All right.
So,
but well, if you do it and you need somebody, let me know.
You know how Brad is. Brad gets things done. So
I know.
We'll probably be doing it. Oh, there's the steal. Oh, nice crossover. I always like seeing a big guy with a crossover like that, you know?
Nice. Well, Hicks has an awful lot of talent. If he can put it together, he could be a really nice ball player. He's still a little rough. He needs to work on it a little bit.
I got to tell you, you know, I'm going to start playing basketball again here. A little pickup games over at the Y and everything. Nothing big. But the one thing I'm going to work on is my Euro step. Jamo's going to have the Euro step at 60. So Glenn says no way. You say no on the camera.
You know, it doesn't even tease me anymore. I don't know where you guys get this gumption to want to try to do it.
I died on the corner. I died right in that corner.
I know you did.
And I want to play. Oh, that'll be a fun.
Well, you know, about 3 years ago, I was getting out of a bunker, a sand trap bunker in Indiana at a tournament, and I pulled the calf muscle. And I thought it was my Achilles when it went. It was not. It was the calf.
You got lucky.
And
I mean, have you ever had that cramp?
No. Well, I've had that cramp,
the worst cramp ever.
You know, and that's the one thing that keeps me away from slow pitch softball or basketball or trying to run and do this and that. Is the last thing in the world I want to do is have to worry about my Achilles going, because that ends any chance I have or any thought I have of playing more golf. So.
Well, I'm starting in a couple of weeks where I'm going to really start running again. I'm getting the feeling back in my feet because my plantar fasciitis is crap from, you know, all of my years of playing, you know, all that fed ball and ruining my feet.
Yep.
But I just, you know, I'd like to go over there and just throw a couple up and, you know, have some fun. I mean, I'm not going to do anything like that, you know. I'm not going to go to Brad Morrison's, Todd Robson and Jimmy Schwinn and all them guys.
Yep.
That's scary basketball still.
Oh, I know.
Marty Schroeder.
Yeah, they're still.
No, I'm not going to do that.
They're still going at it hard.
I suppose if I had the wind, it wouldn't bother me, but I would be. I mean, they still play hardcore basketball. And like Jimmy Schwinn's son, you know, he's at half court shooting threes and making them all. You know, it's like, why even go down there?
Right.
You know? So, but Todd's had shoulder surgery, Todd Robson did, and he said, you know, I think I'm going to try and play. So we'll see. 10-point stretch lead right now.
I don't get it.
I know.
You know.
'64, '50.
You know, maybe it's my memory still good. I can remember back and tell good stories.
I played till I was 50. Well, I was 56, 56 when I died on the court. So that was my last. That was the last one for me.
My last one was 33. That was when my back went out.
Yourself.
My back went out.
You hurt yourself.
That's I herniated.
The only thing I ever did was pull my finger this way. This finger went this way.
I herniated a disc in my back, and that was the end of basketball. Yeah.
I love this game. I love what it did to me. Cardinal Stritch, what it did. And Coach McQuaid, who was here, and I was out at Swanton. For many, still one of my dear friends. And Brian Williams. They're just... changed my whole life. And,
and what people don't realize about me is, as much as I like golf, in my house, basketball was everything.
Oh, yeah.
My father played on a state championship team or a state semifinalist team that lost to Jerry Lucas in 1957 at Maycumber.
Wow.
And he won two AAU championships, national championships, and basketball was everything in our house. And so he and I were together, this week, Thursday was 25 years since my father passed away. Oh. So that was Denny Winkowski, and you know, he was it's funny because I just saw the movie a week ago, Superman is Dead. Well, he was Superman to me, and so
that's cool.
I still think of him every time. If the phone rings on Sunday night, because the one night we talked was Sunday night. After the golf tournament was done, you know, it'd be 8 o'clock, and he and I would talk about the golf tournament. We'd talk about the Celtics, because we were both Celtics fans, you know, who they played on Sunday. We'd talk about the football games. And that was our one night when we would chat. And
That's so cool. You know, my dad really wasn't into the sporting end of things, and he was a baseball guy. And
I can't pass.
He doesn't pass the ball. Ref's throwing Winkowski the ball. We're starting something here, folks. No, but my dad taught me all this.
Yep.
My dad taught me how to be an announcer, how to this and that. And I hope he's looking down, smiling, and saying, wow, he's doing what he wanted to do. But I had some of the greatest coaches that were just like my dad, you know, and especially this game and this school.
Yep.
You know.
Yeah, there have been some great coaches at this school. And
but, you know, when you and I went to, it was so different. I mean, we were all hardcore City League. There was so much talent in the City League.
Correct.
All the way around, whether
Correct.
It be Central, you know, Wade, because Wade had Luke Murphy and all of those guys, and then, you know, Thames as it got older. And
think about it. When we played, the couple years that we played, there were 3 NBA players and 20 Division I athletes
who didn't
go on to play in the NBA, but certainly, you know, were fantastic players.
Right. Well, you had Sean Reed, you had Mitchell, you had, of course, Jimmy Jackson, a little younger than us, and the Ramsey brothers.
You had Hobson and Mitchell.
Denny.
You had Sean Reed, you had Eric Newsom, you had Brian Miller, Brian Borchert, Don Newhart at St. John's, Greg Pope and Eric Newsom at Rogers. You had Anthony Sutton at Libby.
Oh, yeah.
You had... you know, there was Derek Hopkins, who played college basketball at Central.
Right.
You had Dan Kubacki, who played college baseball from Central. You had myself, who played, you know, golf in college. You had Clayton Stidham that played at Central, who got drafted for baseball that year, you know. And so
that's just
our school. And, you know, you went through that whole list.
Yeah.
You had Luke Murphy from Wade, who you know, he said, it was funny because he told us he played for the Washington Generals.
The Generals, yeah.
He lost 247 games in a row and got to keep his job.
I promised Luke that I've got to get him in.
And for those that don't know, the Washington Generals play the Harlem Globetrotters. And if you look at the roster of the Washington Generals, those guys are all former college players that joined the Generals.
You know, we forgot a big name. Truman Clater.
Well, he's older than us, though. Yeah. He was a little older than us.
Yep. Truman, I know he's still repping. I haven't got to see him this year, though. Great guys.
Well, and the forgotten guy is Donald Collins, who played, went to Washington State and played, and then played in the NBA. He's kind of the forgotten guy because he moved away.
Right.
And
all right, Lipsick's got 60. There we go. What a game. Thanks to Epiphany of the Lord Parish for helping us out here. Brogan Colonial Bank, Phelan Orthodontics, Harrison Floors. Of course, the one and only Chris Tucker.
Absolutely.
He's helped me out a lot.
He's a good guy.
I'm telling you, he's got to keep having kids because I love DJing for his kids.
He's got 14, doesn't
Amen.
He? I mean, who knows how many he's got.
Coming up in June.
Yeah.
June or July. It might be July. I think it's the end of June or first of July. marrying into the Lake family there.
Really?
Lake High School boy.
Yeah.
Yeah, they got,
all right.
That's the Reddick family. You know?
Okay.
So, you know, and the Reddicks were just such incredible. Hey, Hon. Can you do me a favor?
Yeah.
Your phones are messing up our Thank you.
Or just move away.
Down a little bit. Thank you. Yeah, because I noticed it's the cell phones do that. So 54 seconds left in this one. Yeah, I think you were right, Scotty. You said it early. Fatigue has started setting in here.
Well, that was, you know, you could see it. Lammers has had really a good game, but
sure.
He missed about four free throws here in the third and fourth quarters, and they just weren't able to get open like they got open in the first half. That extra, that loss of about a quarter step was the difference.
Yep,
and
yep.
Stritch upped it up. You know, you're looking at Lipstick's got 62. They had 35 at the half, so they're a little under that.
Starters are back in. Actually, I'll get this right here for you. For 45 seconds left. Burton missed the first one.
Well, Coach Harris for Stritch will be relieved with tonight's win. Lipstick's got, you know, has had a nice game. They played well, but Stritch didn't play their best, and I think Coach Harris will be. Relieved that they got the win tonight.
28 seconds left to go. I think Stritch is going to have a couple of days to, you know, mend. You know, two games in a row.
Yep.
I don't know where they're going to be at Tuesday. Actually, I think I might. Oh, no, I don't have it. Get a little relaxation.
Well, a very emotional game last night. Then you have senior night tonight, so there'll be a little bit of a letdown for a couple days now.
Relax, yep. Watch the Peyton Manning, Eli Manning
show.
I can't wait to watch that.
For the Super Bowl?
Tomorrow, for the Pro Bowl.
Oh, for the Pro Bowl. I won't watch any of that.
Flag football?
Yeah.
Oh, I think it's going to be hilarious.
It might. Maybe I'll watch it.
Because
maybe I was.
Both Peyton Manning and Eli are going to have microphones.
Yeah.
That's the only reason I would watch that.
Maybe. I'll be in my chair ready for Pebble Beach tomorrow to watch the golf.
True,
so.
Too. I'm going to spend a little time getting the man cave ready for Super Bowl so I can, you know, make my Velveeta and chili dip.
Okay.
Dip, you know, and
good for you.
And have that. Watch a little football. I have no horse in the ring this time, so my Dolphins aren't in it. So, but Tua finally is out of protocol. It's like woo.
He's gonna bump his head on a door, and he's gonna get back into protocol.
I know. The worst feeling in the world is when you open the cabinet door and then hit the bottom of it.
Yeah.
That is a concussion right there. It is. 24 seconds left in this one. What are they calling here? Well, they're going to call Adam Burton. Well. He puts these two down. It's a three-point game. He's in the double bonus, too. They're both in the double bonus.
Oof. Yeah, Lammers has had a hard time
now,
just throwing it in there. It's five or six, yeah.
We got the second one.
Looks like Lipsick will foul right away. And now my call for Stritch. Burton is the guy you want fouled. He's made some free throws. I think he missed one in the last couple, but he should be okay. I'd like to have him at the line every time.
Double bonus time. First one's up.
His ball goes in really soft.
Isn't that weird? It's kind of got the...
It goes in and it just kind of catches in the net.
Nice and easy, smooth. Got the nice rhythm. Got them both.
Well, it goes in soft. I can't tell. I can't see from that far away whether his ball has a lot of rotation to it. When the ball goes in the net that soft, that means it doesn't have a whole lot of rotation to it. So.
Oh, that ball's gone. I've done that. I have. Just for the record. Wow.
I can say I haven't done that.
I have.
Not even in my day.
Yeah. I used to have some jumpers on me.
Mike, as usual, thank you for inviting me. This was an absolute ball, as usual. And
I know.
What a great game. These are both two pretty good teams. Lipsick's got a nice team. If I were them, I would just wish they had two more players. If they had just some depth. They don't have much depth. But I think they did a really nice job in the first half. And boy, they're a good team. But Stritch is going to go as far as Burton will take them.
Exactly. And keep up with our website at ToledoSportsNetwork.com. Of course, BCSN Live Games, too, so make sure you do that. And for Scott Winkowski, Glenn Forbush, the maestro, the man, the myth, the legend, Glenn Forbush on camera did a nice job for us. Folks, we're going to cut this one short. We're done. God bless you all. Take care, and we will see you very soon. Our final once again tonight, Colonel Stritch 72, Lipsick 66. Folks, take care and God bless. I'm